Hi there, I'm Christian and you're watching A Dev Story. Today, I'm continuing a series of videos where I'll be talking about the type of technical interviews. In my previous video, I covered the screening interview process, and if you missed it, don't sweat it, just check out the link. Today, I'm covering the technical knowledge interview. The technical knowledge interview usually lasts about 1 hour, but it could also have multiple sessions. This type of interview could be either an automated test, or it could be done by a person. When it's run by a person, that person is usually a software developer. If it's an automated test, it's usually like a certification exam, and you will see things like what does this part of the code does, or what are these keywords used for, and you know, simple selection type of answers allowed. When it isn't automated, it can cover multiple areas, and in different companies, they focus on different things. Most of the big tech companies try to focus on computer science fundamentals and object orientation, this type of more generic questions. While smaller companies or contractor-based recruiting could focus more on specific technologies. If it's run by a person, then you could have different formats. For example, the typical questions answers could be something like, what do you know about scalability? What is the difference between horizontal scaling and vertical scaling? Or what is the difference between concurrency and parallelism? These type of questions. Or it could also be presented as an exercise where both the interviewer and the candidate are going through the exercise and the interviewer is going to be asking more questions about specific areas that they want to know more. If it's an exercise, the interviewer could ask something like, let's build an e-commerce site. Let's say that we have these requirements and you need to serve 10 million of requests per second. How would you do it? Then the candidate would probably start touching some of the scaling topics and the interviewer will follow up on that. So why would you prefer to add more hardware or not? Why would you prefer to have multiple servers instead of one? These type of questions, which will allow the interviewer to know more about what is the exact knowledge that this candidate has in these topics. The technical knowledge interview has several pros for both the candidate and the interviewer. The main benefits for the interviewer is that you will get a good overview of the candidate. You can get from the technical skills, but you also get the soft skills. You can know how the candidate explains certain topics, how do they take feedback, or how do they express themselves during a debate. Also, even when I'm not a big fan of them, automated tests can provide a time-efficient and more easily measure the candidate's knowledge. For the candidate, the main benefit is that you have more leeway and you have more flexibility in how you reply to the answers than, for example, in the screening process. During this type of interview, it's okay to not know all the answers and you can ask follow-up questions or you can say to the interviewer, I don't know this, but I know this other topic if it's related. So as a candidate, you can express yourself better and show a bigger picture of the things that you know. Also, as a candidate, you get a glimpse of what it's like to work in the company because you will get another software developer with whom you will be discussing these technical topics. The main con that I see on the technical knowledge interview is when it's done with the automated test. And that's because as an interviewer, you get less visibility on the skills of the candidate. And also as a candidate, you get less leeway and less chances to explain similar topics or, you know, side topics that could be relevant in the discussion. Another big challenge for the interviewer, specifically when it's done in person, is to try to keep a great candidate experience while making sure that you can cover all the topics. And this can be hard because sometimes you want to actually cover all the topics, but you don't want to shoot all the questions directly to the candidate. You want it to sound natural. You want it to sound like a conversation, right? But you need to actually cover all the topics to evaluate the candidate. And you need to, I don't know, depending on your company, but you might want to cover concurrency or data structure or subject orientation. And you need to connect the questions in a natural way and not just shooting the questions to the candidate. So in that sense, the question design for the interviewer are harder than, for example, in the screening interview. So the main tips for the interviewer really depends on your needs, but if it's possible, try to do the interview in person. I think you get more information about the candidate. It's a nicer experience also for the candidate. So try to avoid the automated tests unless you know you are actually looking for someone knowing exactly about this and this and this and that. Make sure that the questions are well designed, they sound natural, you can connect them very easily, and also allow the candidate to expand on any of the questions. Also, if possible, try to go with the exercise one instead of the format of question answer. I think it's a nicer experience, and it's also kind of fun both as a candidate and as interviewer when you have an exercise and go through it, even though you're getting, you know, questions about the specific topics during that exercise. For the candidates, the more that you can know about what are the topics that are going to be discussed during the technical knowledge interview, the better. Keep in mind that larger tech companies usually focus more on computer science fundamentals than specific technologies. Even in larger tech companies, there are usually specializations. You will get different questions if you go for a backend position, a front-end, or a mobile developer, for example. Of course, in any of the questions, try not to go too long, but just say something, expand a little bit, and allow the interviewer to follow up with the more questions if needed. The technical knowledge interview is usually complementary to the take-home test or the live coding test. So if you want to know more about those type of interviews, don't miss the rest of the series. So that was the technical knowledge interview. What do you think about it? Do you think it should always be included in the interview process? What has been your experience with it? Let me know in the comment sections below. Thank you very much for watching, and see you next time.